Hello, my name is Brian Wysor. I'm the interim dean for the School of Social and Natural Sciences here at Roger Williams University. I'm also a professor of marine biology and the program coordinator for the high school marine biology camp. And I wanted to take a little bit of time today to share with you some of the details of the high school marine biology camp, give you an idea of the day-to-day kinds of activities, and then also leave you with my email address and a telephone number, which you can feel free to call or text if you have questions about the camp. And I will try to get back in touch with you as soon as possible. The High School Marine Biology Camp at Roger is a 7-day college residential experience. Students live in the dorms for the duration of the camp, where there are three resident assistants who are college students, current college students who are majoring in biology and marine biology, aquaculture and aquarium science, and so on. So students have a good chance to meet with current students, and then they'll also interact with our expert faculty across a variety of disciplines in marine ecology or ichthyology or seaweed biology, oceanography. So they get good exposure to the range of subdisciplines within this broad category of marine science or marine biology while exploring our natural ecosystems in Rhode Island, the ocean state. Here's the week at a glance. You can see of a pretty packed schedule from usually starting around 7 a.m. and ending around 7 p.m. or so. In the evening, students usually hang out with the RAs, play games, take walks around campus, and so on. But it's a nice social activity that is complemented by exciting field trips and laboratory work throughout most of the week. Our first day is a day where we have tended to give a guest lecture on seaweed biology. That's me at last year's camp, and just provide some orientation about these important habitat-forming organisms that we'll see throughout our stay. You can see on the paper in front of the students are dried seaweeds pressed on paper. Students will have a chance to make some of those for their own to take home with them if they want. And just a chance that we can start to get to know each other, talk a little bit about some of aspects of marine science. And that's a pretty typical day for us, is in the evening after dinner, we have a guest lecture in some area of expertise represented by the faculty in the department. That's complemented with some pool work where we have a chance to get in the water, practice snorkeling. The camp can provide snorkeling gear, or students bring their own masks, fins, and snorkels. I absolutely love getting out in the field with students and snorkeling, exploring these natural habitats, seeing the organisms firsthand. It's really exciting, and it's so fun to do that with students as well. I like to get in the water in the pool in a nice controlled environment where we can practice with some of that gear. For some students, they won't have much snorkeling experience. Others come in with lots of experience. It works either way, but here's just a chance to get in, get oriented a little bit, and again, get to know each other and just have some fun together. Our first full day of the camp, we're generally out on the Invincible Spirit. It's a 30-foot island hopper research vessel owned by the university. It can hold 18 students, a captain and a mate. And so our whole group can go out and we do some water column profiling and phytoplankton and zooplankton collection. So we sample water from different levels, top, middle, and bottom, basically. And we measure some water quality parameters like nutrient concentration, salinity, temperature, and chlorophyll concentration. We also do some TOWS with plankton nets to look at the constituent microorganisms, both the plant and the animals, and then bring some samples back to the lab where we filter them and extract chlorophyll so we get a better understanding of how much and what kinds of plankton are present. We complement that with microscopy work as well, so we get a chance to explore the very heterogeneous microflora and microfauna of the area. So it's really an opportunity to just explore and see what's in the water in ways we don't often get to look at them. The second full day, third day of the camp, we're often in the field seining. So students pull this net through the water, and tend to collect a lot of small kinds of organisms. You can see students here sorting through the variety of different fish that we pick up from this sampling technique, as well as some of the algae there as well. So we try to see how many different kinds of organisms we can collect on these trips. And importantly, students are very engaged, very involved with this work. We couldn't actually do it if we didn't have all hands on deck. So it's a lot of fun to get in the water and see what we can find. On the next day, we are often in the field sampling for seaweed biodiversity. It's very near and dear to my heart. That's my specialty. And we bring specimens back to the lab and we can prepare those herbarium specimens, but we also have a chance to look at them under the microscope. There is extraordinary diversity and they are so easy on the eyes. They're beautiful to look at, to inspect, to kind of understand what their biodiversity is and how they're important in the natural environment as sources of food for other organisms, as habitat, of course, producers of oxygen as well. So we can get up close and personal with the seaweed biodiversity. There's over 300 species of seaweeds in Rhode Island, so pretty neat area to look at that. We'll have a chance to go paddling on a shallow coastal embayment. This is called Ninnegrit Pond down in southern Rhode Island. And really outstanding habitat that we get to explore here. A lot of seagrasses, soft bottom habitats, sometimes really exciting groups of fish that come in and out. And we also have a chance to get over to a bit of a higher energy sandy beach with breaking waves as well. So again, we get to explore this broad diversity of habitats throughout Rhode Island. The afternoon on that day of where we start paddling down in Ninnegrit, we are often out on this research vessel called the Captain Burt, which does a lot of surveys, standard regular surveys. We go out, we get to see what kind of fish and seaweed and invertebrates are out as well. And a lot of fun to go out, super hands-on. And this sampling technique tends to catch a little bit larger, some faster fish. So nice contrast from the seining technique that we used earlier in the week. And then our sixth full day of the camp, we are off to Plymouth, Massachusetts, where we get on a whale watch vessel. It's a 3-hour trip. We get to see several different kinds of whales, as well as dolphins, and sometime we see some sharks out there as well, some harbor seals and so on. So really great, charismatic groups of organisms kind of cap off the week of being in and on the water. So the camp, overall, it's a really great opportunity to get exposed to campus life, get to know a few marine biology, aquaculture, and aquarium science majors, see the facilities, see how we work in this environment, and get out and about around Rhode Island and explore the fabulous ocean state. We're really lucky that we've got these resources so close. It really makes for a really rich experience because we're not spending a whole lot of time traveling. We can get out on the water right away. So every day we're in and or on the water. And I like to say it's all of the science, none of the homework. And really great working with our students and campers as well. Departure Saturday morning, and away students go with new friendships, new collaborations, possibly, and perhaps future friends at Roger Williams University if you like what you see when you're here. Again, I'll just remind you, my name is Brian Wysor. I am the interim dean for the School of Social and Natural Sciences, which is home to the Department of Biology, Marine Biology, and Environmental Science, also Aquaculture and Aquarium Science. And we encourage you to check out those programs, even if you're not participating in the Marine Biology camp. And you are welcome to email me or call me or text me at the phone number shown there, because I would be happy to answer any questions that you have about the camp. Specific questions if you're enrolled, general questions if you're just thinking about enrolling. And I look forward to connecting in the near future. Take care.